So I just got through reading A Heart So White by Javier Marías, which had some great meditations on the whole honeymoon period of a marriage, and I thought it'd be interesting to look forward to when after the kids popped out and you experience the joys of raising children, but kind of transform into frustration when things get settled and yeah, you're living in a good school district now, tired all the time and your wife's never in the mood and all the stuff you're into gets taken away. But there's all these soccer moms in the neighborhood that are hot as fuck and you got these white hot flames of lust fever licking your balls. One day you're like, honey, I'm gonna get something up, and you jump in the van and be like, fuck this shit. With all these attractive young couples strutting around at birthday parties, you start to ponder certain things. And I wanted to take a look at Couples by John Updike. Even though this book smelled like a bag of smashed assholes, I figure you can consult it like WebMD. Because if you follow the process to its logical conclusion, you know you're going to end up in some weird place. But to really get into it, we're going to have to take it back.
John Updike was born in Pennsylvania in 1932. He was an only child and his parents surrounded him with love and affection. Breastfed until the age of 14, he attended Harvard and enjoyed being a clown on campus. There, he married and quickly raised a family, got himself a nice car, and started on his writing career that would launch him into literary stardom.
Your goes to John Updike.
The town of Ipswich, Massachusetts, is centrally located on the North Shore. The town, founded in 1633, is one of the oldest towns in the United States.
I'd read snatches of Couples here and there, but never really got a good sense of how much snatch there actually was. It's a classic American domestic yawn fest. Snatches of Couples here and there. Never really got a good sense of how much snatch there actually was. I'd read snatches of Couples here and there. Each character was like a Polaroid developing, and it just took extra time for each one to gel and sharpen. On the other hand, in typical Updike fashion, he goes overboard with all the noticing and describing to the point where I consider it actually quintessential bad writing. And you just have to sit there and take it. And there's one woman whose ass Updike describes as being tipped inward like the tiny wheel at the front of a tractor.
That's even better when it falls down.
Moments when these women are spouting off their insecurities in one scene and then having their mouths stuffed full of cock in another are just too few and far between enough for us to pop any real wood. The book specializes more in dissecting the onset and flare-up and eventual burnout of fucking your friends and neighbors. That incestuous coziness at drunken parties where boobs start accidentally popping out of bras, or you decide to play a game of Twister without actually having the Twister mat on hand. Go, 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 shawty, it's your birthday. We gon' party like it's your birthday. We gon' party like it's your birthday. I mean, do you really want to play volleyball against a guy who can do that with his arms? It's a classic American domestic yawn fest here. A long, slow, steady masturbation session here. Really, he's only engaging himself. It's a spectacle that others can't help but peek their heads around into the bedroom to witness. And it's all the more disturbing because the whole time, this dude has got this unabashed, impish twinkle in his eye. The question at the end of this book, though, then is, whose face is the one getting facialized?